It's the deadliest natural disaster in American history. A massive hurricane bringing 120 mile per hour winds, 9 inches of rain in just a single day. Storm surge of more than 15 feet, drowning a city that sits just 8 feet above sea level. 8,000 people dead, 10,000 homeless. In an age of extreme weather, you can grow numb to statistics like those. But here's the thing, those statistics don't come from an age of extreme weather. Because the deadliest natural disaster in American history happened in Galveston, Texas, in 1900. These days, it seems that extreme weather is everywhere you look. Catastrophic wildfires in Southern California, an outbreak of over 150 tornadoes that hammered parts of the South and Midwest in 2023, the 2024 hurricane that brought devastation to the mountains of North Carolina. And when you consider those events alongside the broader fears of climate change and the onslaught of media stories suggesting things are only going to get worse, you can see why many Americans worry that extreme weather is going to turn the country into an uninhabitable wasteland, a process scientists refer to as New Jerseyification. But here's where the story gets complicated and surprisingly reassuring. While Americans may be more worried about extreme weather than ever before, the reality is that we're safer from the consequences of extreme weather than ever before. Here's what we mean. It's no accident that the Galveston hurricane of 1900 was the deadliest weather event in American history, because almost all of the deadliest such events in American history happened a long time ago. A heat wave in 1936 that killed about 5,000 people, an enormous flood that killed 4,000 Californians and destroyed one-third of all the property in the state in 1862. The San Francisco earthquake of 1906, which killed 3,000 people and left 400,000 homeless. By contrast, since 1940, the number of natural disasters that killed over 1,000 people was just 3. A heat wave in 1980, Hurricane Katrina in 2005, and Hurricane Maria in 2017. How could things have changed so much? Because of a counterintuitive principle. The most important factor in determining how much damage results from a natural disaster isn't how intense the event itself is, it's how well protected the people in its path are. And on that front, things have gotten a lot better in recent decades. Better building codes have hardened buildings against risks from flooding, high winds, and earthquakes. And according to FEMA, new safeguards adopted since the year 2000 have prevented about $1.6 billion in damage. Long-term forecasts and early warning systems have given people more time to prepare for incoming hurricanes, with the technology improving dramatically in recent years. Today, we're less vulnerable to extreme heat than we used to be. In 1957, 10% of American households had air conditioning. By 2020, nearly 90% did. Not only has that made us safer, it's also reshaped the country. For example, a world with abundant air conditioning changed Miami from this into this, which is real progress. But also from this into this, which is maybe not progress. To see how much of a difference preparation can make, you only have to take another look at Galveston. In the years after the 1900 hurricane, the city built a seawall to prevent another catastrophe, a protective barrier it still uses to this day. How much of a difference did it make? While the hurricane of 1900 killed about 8,000 people, a storm that was just as strong hit the city in 1915 and killed 12. Now, you might be thinking, it's great that people are safer, but what about all the economic damage from extreme weather? Isn't that at an all-time high? And the answer to that question is yes, but maybe not for the reasons we'd think. Between 1990 and 2017, the global cost of weather disasters increased by 74%, which seems like a menacing statistic about how much worse climate disasters became. But here's the thing, the damage from natural disasters that have nothing to do with climate, things like earthquakes or volcanic eruptions, went up more than twice as fast, by 182%. And there's a reason for that. Those increasing damages don't necessarily mean that more places are being destroyed or that the disasters are more severe than they used to be. In many cases, it just means that the property in the path of destruction is more valuable than it used to be. Think about how much of America's priciest real estate, whether it's seaside property in Florida or a house on the cliffs in California, is located in disaster-prone areas. In fact, when you use a statistic that allows you to compare apples to apples, how much damage a natural disaster does as a percentage of a region's entire economy, the number has actually gone down by over 75% in recent years. So, the good news? We're safer than we think. While we still need to be on guard for natural disasters and take concerns about the climate seriously, the fears of an imminent apocalypse are overblown. But there's bad news too, which is that there are a lot of people in the world that are still way more vulnerable to extreme weather than Americans are. One of the best predictors of how well your country will fare in a disaster is how wealthy it is. For a tangible example of this, you can look at Haiti and the Dominican Republic, two countries that share the same island. In 2004, the Dominican Republic was more than 250% wealthier than Haiti. When a hurricane hit the island that year, 19 Dominicans died. The death toll in Haiti, over 3,000. And even wealthier nations can feel the sting of this if they don't take the necessary precautions. A queasiness about developing new energy sources in Europe, for instance, left much of the continent dependent on Russian gas. When Moscow cracked down on those exports because of the war in Ukraine, it sent energy prices soaring in the middle of winter, leading to an estimated 68,000 deaths from the cold. But here's the most important thing to remember. In most cases, we can avoid tragedies on that scale. With proactive planning, continued technological innovation, and economic growth, society can protect itself from the worst Mother Nature can throw at us. The worst Miami can throw at us? That's a different question.